Sorry, another size problem. So, another part. So we stopped on the tags. And we just discovered a special tweak that allows you to make tag visible on the radar. Okay, wait. To demo this specially, we're gonna edit the arena because we kind of screwed this up. Oh, sorry guys. Hello. So let's go to our mountain. And as you can see, there's a ship that we placed a tag. And it's marked. So yeah, it's a cool thing. I wonder if you change the... And as I expect, let's copy this. Actually, let's remove this. And let's try to make this So yeah, I'm not talking. Let's make this. I want to demo you guys what we can do with this radar thing. So you can practically control this with logic by simply turning off, turning on the tags, which allows you to do some pointing for the objects, but I think there's a bug. I think it should show the label. And I think that actually would be also useful in Little Big Planet 2. Such object pointing, highlighting thing like this. Oh, awesome cutting object. Oh, so as you can see, it actually applies to the object, not tag position. So it's pretty cool. It's you can actually change the color of the stack, I think. Okay, so this is tags and got interesting radar function. which is something new. Something I actually didn't know about. And it's pretty cool. Fun thing. Okay, so let's continue. Button. Button is standard button, as you may expect. Best used with the snap to the ground. And it's button. Just flutter. And you can invert it. And so on. Nothing special, actually. Let's demo this on the light. When you drive it through, it will light the light, right? Will lit the light. Here you go. Standard thing. And it's like Little Big Planet 2, right? Okay, next. Impact sensor. Impact sensor works like impact sensor. Doesn't have player got require attack, of course, and label, and that's it. Practically, there's no rigid connection, which is kind of odd. But yeah, it's working like a normal thing. I don't know if it works with cards. I don't know. Speed sensor, like a normal speed sensor, detects speeds. I'm not sure if it's detecting object speed. There's easy way to find out this one. Let's use this. This is dynamic. So we should have something happening over here. Yep, it detects the speed even of object, but it also works on card. When you place it on the checkpoint, it will detect a speed of the player, specific player. Only thing missing is rotation, I mean, speed of specific player that respawn from the checkpoint. Okay. Other thing is reset sensor, which means it's actually another sensor that works only on the. Actually, it's a sensor that only works with the checkpoint. You simply place it on the checkpoint, and it will trigger when player is reset. So, for example, when we got this reset over here, we can make it. Some sound. Oh, by the way, if we're here, I'm gonna show you. UI got a lot of new sounds, which is fun. Let me volume up a little bit. As I said, it got checkpoint sound, which is cool. Standard, let's... Tiki peep up. Transition. Yeah, those sounds, UI sounds like this would be freaking awesome for the Little Big Planet 2, but it isn't. We can use it on carding. Hopefully this will transfer back to the you know. Okay, I'm gonna explain you some later. Now let's control create centrate on reset. So we're gonna reset, and this will sound this will make us hear the sound when we reset. There's also, I think, we need to make it trigger. There's some difference in this. So this is reset sensor. We plug to the reset sensor. We plug the to the reset sensor. We plug sound. So when we reset with our secret cycle button, it will make a sound. You hear that? Yeah. So this is reset sensor. It detects when you when you got killed, respawned, or anything like that. I think there's also tweaks which allow you to detect when you out of bound, when you got reset because you're out of bounds. You can make it reset collect weapons. Don't know. When you hit the hazard, of course, manual, by the way, it means when you press select, so you can punish player for doing that if you want, for example, by slowing him down with the handle trigger. So yeah, select, it's a manual. Water. So when you dive into water, the next then and any, and that's it. So this is reset sensor. Okay, another sensor, it's a race position sensor, as you may expect. It's send percentage of the position. For example, when you last, it sends 0. When you 7, it plays 8, it's gonna be 8. It's gonna be 12, 24, 20, not 24, it's 8. Yeah, it's 20%, 24%, 46%, and so on. You can detect, it's an aux signal sensor, so it doesn't have position, which kind of odd. They could simply get a tweak that allows you to set, but it sends an aux signal of the current position. Right, and of course it only works, it also works on arena. Yeah, it works on everything. There's also position on the arena. You can see on the AI when you play on the play mode, you can see it got one on top. It also works with kill positions, I suppose. Progress sensor, it's only works on track, of course, and it sends percentage of how much race is completed. It will be full when in the beginning it's gonna be 0%. When you make one lap out of three, it's gonna be 23% analog signal, and so on. And when the race is full, it's gonna send full 100%. So this sensor works only in checkpoint, of course, the same as position sensor, and it also. An aux signal. Wait, let's see if there's any tweaks. No, there's not any tweaks. Okay, grab sensor, as you can expect. Other than new stuff, it got require stacks, so you can place, for example, specific player detection by placing tag on the stuff and so on. And also you can detect specific team. For example, you set this to 3, when player from that team number 3 gonna grab the object, it will trigger this. Player 2, team 2, and require tag, it will only detect players with specific tag on the checkpoint. Yeah, standard stuff. Grabble, same as it's a grabble. Of course, you need to make grabble on the specific. This is our grabble. So, for example, when we practice to here, it will detect when we grabble the object, because we make this object grabbable, right? It's like grab sensor, but grabble, grappling hook, yeah. And score sensor. It also detects specific team. Score of specific team? No. Yeah, I think there should be freaking specific player. Yeah. Maybe when you got free for all, the specific player, I don't know. I hope so. And what is most important, same as score giver, you can set the dex 1 point, which is not possible in... Oh, there's actually no 0. It should be 0 also. This is freaking problem. I need to report that. I hope I will be able, because beta ending soon. So you can detect in precisions of one single point, which is not possible in Little Big Planet 2. And for the sake of experiment, let's see. Yeah, looks like it's not limited. Yeah, it's already beyond what Little Big Planet 2 sensor allows. Or maybe not. I think it's 100,000 point maximum. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, so 100,000 points maximum score sensor, right? Yeah, the next one specific players got score. I think you know that. It's works the same as Little Big Planet 2. When you watch this video, I expect you know Little Big Planet 2 stuff. So, yeah. Magic Mouth. Got text, got subtitles too. Got minimum display time, which practically make it cycle appear only specific time. Voice, same as you got gibberish voices. There's really nothing new here. There's not much. There's no voices, new voices over here. But you might be happy that they got also except of the. It also got recorded voice. But wait, what are you gonna be happy about?
Sorry about that, I was getting a mic. I had it on different room.
So you also got voice recording, same as Little Big Planet 2, but it's what is most important thing, it's got freaking great quality. Check this out. I hope you can hear that. Okay, so let's record voice. Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat. But I'm not with the cat. Wow, 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 wow. And now you can see how this is very good quality.
Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat. But I'm not with the cat. Wow, 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 wow.
So as you can, I hope you can hear that. It's actually very good quality. Freaking very good quality. I don't really understand why it is not in Little Big Planet 2. Because I think this is more demanding game than Little Big Planet 2, and it got freaking great quality, same as Mod Nation Racers.
Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat, but I'm not with the cat. Wow, 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 wow.
And the same goes with online communications. Same quality. Freaking awesome. We can control volume.
Hi there, it's me. It's... Hi...
You're freaking joking me.
Hi there. Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat. But I'm... It's me and my awesome cat, but I'm not with the cat.
Oh my freaking god. Oh my freaking god. I didn't know about this. You can tweak the tune of this of the voice.
Hi there, it's me. Hi there, it's me. It's me and my...
Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat. But I'm not with the cat.
This is freaking awesome. I didn't know about this. Oh my god. Man, too bad there's no analog signal to control the tune. It would be freaking more awesome. So yeah, you can control what is new from Little Big Planet 2.
Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat. But I'm not with the cat. Wah, 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 wah.
So you can control volume and tune. Right.
Hi there, it's me. It's me and my awesome cat. But I'm not with the cat.
Okay, as Magic Mouth, you also got trigger range, and that's everything you got here. Trigger radius, of course, and hold time. And skippable. Also, you got actor, you got different visuals, square or round. Let's try it, maybe. Let's try how different it's gonna look. Let's make a round. Let's make actor. Omg. Hold time infinite. Skippable. Oh yeah, skippable. Where's skippable? Okay, let's see what happens if it's not skippable. doesn't work. I don't know, I didn't play with this. Oh, I removed the... Okay, let's make this quick. Again. We make this... voice... Hi there! It's me and my awesome cat, without a cat, so whatever. I'm recording freaking demo for Create Mode. I hope you're gonna like it when I'm gonna upload this.
Hi there! It's me and my awesome cat, without a cat, so whatever. I'm recording freaking demo for Create...
Okay. Oh yeah, one more thing. Actor. There's something wrong with it. Let's see how Square looks like. You can see two different graphics for the Magic Mouth. It's also Square. Let's see. I wonder if you can. It's no different, so I guess it's not implemented yet, the square one. I believe it's one that have texture of the notepad. But okay, this is Magic Mouth, the old, good old Magic Mouth. Oh my god. Next is Motors. Motors is kind of new thing, very new thing. Why I can't place it? So Motors is equivalent of the Motors on the Topic Planet 2, but they work a little bit different. So to demo it, instead of plugging, you know, motor on the top of here and accepting the wall over here. I think this is actually made this way because it's very hard to make this in 3D. Yeah, it might be a little bit hard. So instead of plugging motor on the object like this, you use this motor like that is looks like a kind of object. You tweak how you want to object to rotate. Sync and so on. You plug the object you want to move like this and use it. Now so as you can see it's rotating. And I believe this is actually archering point. Let's try this. Oh, it's moving around. This is really archering point? Yeah, this is our archering point. I think actually when you plug it on the middle, actually I think it's a position point. What? I can't undo this. Oh, okay. I think this is our turning point. No. So yeah, this is like a rotational motor. And it's kind of odd. I didn't play with it much, but yeah, this is how this is equivalent of motors in Little Big Planet 2. Pretty neat. And you can choose multiple objects with using one motor. So for example, we're gonna use our ship. One thing, when you make this, you won't be able to rotate. Oh, yeah, this is archering point. So it makes ship rotate in space. Actually, I believe this is transforming. Yeah. So this object over here is a archering point of the rotation, and you choose multiple like that. It's like a carousel, pretty much. And you can make very large speeds. Whee! So yeah, this is one of the motors, the most basic one. Rotational motor. Rotate motor. And there's power motor, but I don't see this working. Kind of odd. Maybe you need to make a path, I think. Oh yeah, so this is, you can make a paths, seems so, and when you use path picker, oh, so this is the paths, yeah, this is the paths, and it also you can make a sackboat, and sackboat you follow the path. I mean the sackboat, the cart. What the hell? Okay, and now, same as you can believe, you can plug object into this and it will make... object follow specific path that we choose. So yeah, I actually didn't play with Puffs, which makes me even more interesting thing. This actually makes AI follow a specific path. And you can draw paths that you can use for a lot of gadget things. And draw paths like this. And makes or use the path follower, or you can use it with the race brain and make your follow the path, as you can see. So this is follow the path motor. Another one is it's a piston motor. I think we removed our object by mistake in process. And as you can expect, same as all motors, it's like piston. It's the equivalent of piston. Nothing special much here. And we got flip, and we got standard stuff like you see in piston sync, pulse, distance, time, stuff like you see on LittleBigPlanet 1 even. And you got play one, speed scale, too bad there's no positional flipper, curve type, oh! So you can make it movement linear and curve, which it's not available even on LittleBigPlanet 2. It's something cool. So now we make it curve, so it's faster and slower. Okay, so this is piston motor. Pretty nice. And we got hinge motor, which is the back forward motor that is also on LittleBigPlanet 2. And it's rotating objects back and forth like you expect. It's like a rotation motor but with specific angle of working. And of course we got angle and so on, we got orient the path, orient to path, oh, orient to path, I think it will make object, or maybe not, yeah. Same time, pause, something you see in normal rotation. And we got single cycle to do single cycle. This is something I think LittleBigPlanet 2 it doesn't have. Speed, scale, input action. We got curve type, extended, linear, accelerate, deaccelerate, smooth. This is something that LittleBigPlanet 2 doesn't, LittleBigPlanet 1 doesn't have. And look at rotator, I think we might use this here. It rotates object in 3D to point specific things. Yeah, so as you can see, the motor stiffs the object and all the motor, all the movers, rotators are ignored. So it's not, it's not substitute for the movers. So we can make it follow team and so on. But there, oh, there you go, follow tag. So you can make it follow lookup tag. Need target. I'm not sure what the speed, acceleration. There's no linear and so on. But as you can see, it rotates depending on the player. Right? Interesting thing. So yeah, this is all the motors. And I see, so we won't have unexpected cuts like we always did. See you, and we're gonna explain. It's actually gonna be less part, I think. And we're gonna explain some few more stuff.